We'll start just with our shoulders rolling back and down. Take a breath in. Take your arms all the way out. Inhale. And exhale, bring your hands down. Inhale, open the arms out wide. And exhale, hands coming down. Again, breathing in. And exhale, coming down. Let's dedicate our practice today for peace. Peace for ourselves. And peace for all living beings. Take your hands up over your head. Inhale. Open your arms. Take them behind your back. Interlace your fingers. Draw the shoulders back. Just like this. Or maybe you could bring the palms together. Stretching through the shoulders. We'll stay here for two breaths. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Just relax your hands by your sides now. We'll turn our head to the right. Just turn your head gently. Not the rest of the body. Keep the shoulders facing forward. And just take a few breaths here. Just notice if you're standing evenly in both of your feet. Spread your toes out on the floor. Pull up through the thighs. And then we'll turn our head and look to the left. Gently relaxing the shoulders down. Breathing in and breathing out. Breathing in and breathing out. Move back to the center. You bring your right ear down towards the shoulder just gently. You might even like to close your eyes here. Throughout the class today, I'll let you know when we're moving to the next pose before we do. So if you want to have your eyes closed or rest a little deeper in any pose, just feel free just to let go a little. We're going to use this time today to find some space in our day so we can rest and restore. We come up and take the head over to the other side and just gently breathe. Inhale and exhale. Feel your feet grounded to the earth. Connected and strong, while the neck relaxes, breathing slowly. We move back to the center and bring our chin down towards the chest. Just allow your head to feel heavy. We don't have to force this at all. The arms just relaxed by our sides. We'll stay here for a few breaths, releasing through the back of the neck. Sometimes we hold a lot of tension and stress through the neck and shoulders. It's nice to give ourselves a little bit of time here. Two more breaths. Inhale. Just let your head feel heavy. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Lifting your head up. Just lift the chin slightly. Take your eye gaze toward the ceiling. If you'd like to, you could take your head all the way back, but just be careful of your neck if your neck's a little sore. And just eye gaze towards the ceiling and lengthen the front of the neck. Bring the shoulders back. Keep the tummy drawn in so our lower back's not in an arch here. We'll stay here. Continuing breath. Inhale. And exhale. One more. Inhale. And exhale, come back to center, open the arms, all the way to the top, palms come together, and hands come down to your heart center. Lift the right hand up, press your left hand down, stretch even through your wrists and fingers, and then move into a side bend. We'll bring the head down to look towards the bottom hand. Keep this arm right near your ear, take it all the way over, keep reaching long. And then come back, hands come into prayer. Change sides, reaching up, pressing down, and side bend. Arm right near the ear. Keep lifting your body up tall as you stretch. Turn your head towards the bottom hand. And we'll move back, hands come back into prayer. Slightly bend your knees, twist to the right, Look over the right shoulder and come back. Twist to the left. And back to center. Do that again, to the right. And back. And to the left. And back. Lift the arms up. Open the arms. Bring your hands behind you or back. Interlace your fingers again. Look up towards the ceiling, stretching through the chest and shoulders. Breathe in, lift a little taller, and exhale, release your hands. Let's separate our feet just a little way. Then we'll tuck our chin in, we'll roll our body forward. So chin tucks in. If your lower back's a little sore, I want you to have your knees bent and soft. Roll down through your spine, like a cat stretched through your back. We're not aiming to touch the floor here, we're only going where we feel a stretch comfortable. And then we round up through the spine, push the hips forward and roll ourselves all the way back. Restacking the spine, bring the shoulders back. We'll do that again. Tucking in the chin, then the shoulders. Round through the spine, tummy drawing in, rolling down. Try and let your arms relax like a rag doll. If you're holding tension in your neck and your shoulders, your arms might feel very rigid. So I want you just to shake them out a little bit. And let the whole head relax down as well. So the neck is releasing. You don't have to look forward at the moment. Just let your neck relax. And you can keep just releasing through your arms by swinging your arms a little bit. And we're staying here for 3 falling out breaths all together. So we inhale into our upper back and exhale like this. Breathe in. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale, and then just let yourself fall forward here gently. All right, you can soften your knees as much as you need to. We'll be coming down onto the floor. So bend your knees, bring your hands to the ground, and the knees sitting just underneath your hips. Now, we try not to sink into the shoulders, so press away from the floor so the shoulders stay strong. We'll spread our fingers out wide. From here, we'll look forward and breathe in. Bring the chest up and the tummy down. Then we exhale round the spine. Tuck the chin in, look toward the navel. Inhale through the nose, looking forward and then up. Elbows stay straight. Exhale into cat stretch, rounding the spine. Inhale, chest comes down, we look up. Exhale, round the spine up. You can do this with your eyes closed. We'll do 2 more. Inhale, looking forward, shoulders back. Exhale, round the spine, all the way up. Come back to neutral and sit all the way back on your heels. Extended child's pose, head comes down. Just go where you can. If your knees are a little tight, that's okay to be up a little bit higher, but try to rest your head. Maybe you'll bring your hands in like this and just rest your forehead on your hands. Just do what you need to do to try to release tension through here, through the neck and the shoulders. Okay, so from here, let's move in and out of the pose. So we'll come up onto all fours, breathe in. And then exhale and sit all the way back. Inhale, coming up, keep the elbows straight. And exhale, sitting all the way back. Inhale, forward. And exhale, back. Head comes down as well. One more. Inhale, lift. And exhale, sitting all the way back. Now let's move back up onto all fours again. This time we'll round our back into a cat stretch, arching. And as we go to breathe in, this time we'll lift the right leg up in the air and look forward. We'll start lengthening out through the leg. Exhale, bring your knee in towards your nose, round your back up high. Inhale, stretch the leg up, look forward. Exhale, knee comes in, round your back up. Inhale, extend. And exhale, knee into the nose, arch your back up high, and reach the leg out one more time. We'll keep it here. We're going to cross it over the left foot, place the toe on the floor, and then turn our head to look over it, our foot. So at the moment, see if you could just roll onto the big toe side of your foot so the hip lifts up on the right side a little bit more. And as you're turning your head, not straining the neck, you're just getting a nice C shape through the spine so you can open up the right side of your body. Just take a few breaths there. Then we'll turn our head back to be level again. Take the right leg, bring the knee down. Sit back in extended child's pose. Head comes right down. And move back up onto all fours. Round the back into a cat stretch. And as you breathe in, lift the left leg up now. So we look forward, inhale. Exhale, round the back knee in. Inhale, lift up. Keep the elbows straight and the shoulders open. Exhale, knee in. Inhale, lift. Exhale, knee in. And extend the leg out again. Last one, and stay here. Cross it over the right foot. Place the toe on the floor. And then turn your head to look over at the foot. Again, we'll roll onto the big toe side of the foot to keep our hip lifted and twisting through the spine. So let's continue the breath, inhaling and exhale, pressing away from the floor and exhale. One more breath in and out. Move back to center, bring the foot back, knee comes down. Sit right back in extended child's pose. And from here, we'll lift ourselves up, hands come off the floor, step the right foot forward into a lunge. Nice big step. Maybe you've got blocks here, but maybe you don't. So we'll start without the blocks, but if you do have them, you'd like to put them underneath your hands, you're welcome to do that. So from here, we'll move in and out of this stretch. So we're starting our lunge, and then we move back, straightening the front leg and lifting up the toe. So your hand again can be at the thigh. Or if you have a little bit more movement through the body, you could have your hands on the floor the whole time. So you can take that option. So bend the knee, come forward, look up. Exhale, straighten the leg. Inhale, bend the knee, look forward, shoulders back. And then straighten the leg, toe lifting. Again, bend the knee. And then coming back. You might even be able to bring your head down. Just go to your level, bend the knee, and then straighten the leg. And bend the knee again and stay here. Now from here, we'll walk our hands up onto our knee, and then place the right hand down. If you have a block there, you could put a block. Otherwise, just keep your hand on your leg. Left arm is up in the air, and we'll side bend over the bent knee side. So maybe your hands might touch the floor, maybe they don't, a block or a book. Maybe your hand just stays on the level of this. So we continue just to press the hip forward here. Keep the tummy drawn in and breathe in and just gently breathe out. Inhale and exhale. So some of our movements in dynamic, in stretch yoga are dynamic, they move in and out. And others we hold still. So at the moment we'll bring our hands down and we'll put them just on the inside of our legs so the right foot can step over a little bit to the right and then hands can be on the floor just on the inside of that foot. So for this next pose we'll hold for a little bit longer. You can be here. If you need to have a prop underneath your hands, you can have your hands up. Otherwise you can come down even further if you have that movement in the hip. You can come down onto your forearms. And we just don't want to hold rigid through our shoulders or our neck, so just stay in place where we can breathe in and out comfortably. I think in a stretch class, it's really important to continue to come back to your breath. So if you feel like you're holding your breath or straining to breathe, then the whole body is under stress, including your breath. So if we can move back into a state where we can breathe comfortably in the pose, then your body will feel safe and then it'll allow you just to go that little bit further. As soon as you push really hard into a stretch, everything's just going to hold on really tight. So let's just listen to our body tonight and move with ease. We'll work towards staying in a pose a little bit longer here. And if you've only just joined in yoga for the very first time, welcome. I hope that you enjoy the benefits of yoga and you sleep really well tonight. It's a really nice way that we can finish our evening after a hectic day. So let's move up from here. We'll come up onto our hands. We'll take the right foot all the way back. Let's sit it back in child's pose again and just stretch out here. So if child's pose really isn't working for you tonight, it's okay. You don't have to come all the way back. You could even do a cat stretch or even stretch your leg out. That's fine. You just choose what you need to do for your resting pose between. We'll come up now and step the other foot forward. So left foot steps forward, big step. And again, you can bring your blocks in, have your hands on the floor here. Lunging forward, bring your shoulders back. Take a breath in. Then we'll exhale and move back so that heel lifts up. Again, you can bring your hand up onto your thigh, not against your knee though. We don't want to push against this joint. Come forward, fingers on the floor, shoulders back. Exhale, straighten the leg, toe lifts up. Bend the knee. Inhale. And exhale, toe lifts up, head comes down. Breathing in, bend the knee. And exhale, coming back. Again, come forward. And last time back. And then from here, we'll bend the knee again. We'll bring our hands up onto our knee. We'll move into that side bend we did on the other side. So the left hand could come down onto a block if you have one. Or maybe you'll keep your hand on your leg. Take your right arm in the air and then side bend. So as we side bend, try not to back bend as well. We'll just move to the side, open the right side of the body up. We keep the muscles of the glutes tight, so bottom muscles, just to support your lower back. Keep lifting your lower spine up nice and tall. Notice how you're breathing. Try to relax your neck a little bit more. Yeah, bring your shoulders down a little bit more. All right, come back. Hands come onto the inside of that foot. You can walk that left foot over just a little bit more if you like. Give yourself a bit of space. Your hands come down. So you might need to slide back a little bit more. If you have a cushion and you need it underneath your knee, there's an option. All right, so from here, we can stay in this position. Or maybe you're coming down further onto your elbows, you just take your option. So as I was talking about before, how we sometimes hold our breath and don't even realise it, especially in our yoga poses when we're learning something new, balancing or whatever pose it might be, and we hold our breath, once we're aware of it, then we can change it. And I think the same thing happens day to day when we're outside and things are going on. We're under a lot of pressure and stress. We don't realize that we're breathing really high up into our chest or rapid breath, or maybe we're even holding our breath because we are stressed. So the most amazing thing about being a human being is that we've got this conscious control of the way we breathe, that we can actually shift the way we breathe. If we notice that we're holding our breath, we have the ability to change it. We have the ability to notice if the breath is rapid and then make that change. So today, let's practice it now on the mat. And then we can take it out into every day when we move around outside. So we breathe in really quite slowly into the belly, and then you exhale really quite slowly as well. So the conscious breath slows right down. And then what that does is slows the nervous system down. Everything moves back into a state where it can heal and where we can see a little bit clearer. So clarity of mind and calming of the mind is really important. Let's use the tools we've been practicing all these years and put them into practice now. Let's come up onto our hands and we'll take that foot all the way back. Let's move it into another variation, maybe child's pose, or this time you could take your knees out a little bit wider. This is called mounting heart pose. You sit on your heels with the knees out wide. Then bring your arms forward. So your arms come forward and chest comes down. You can rest your chin or head to the side. Maybe your forehead is touching the floor. But maybe this is really uncomfortable and you need to bring your fists in underneath your head. And rest there. We won't be here for very long, maybe about four more breaths. Just let the chest relax down. And we'll have some moments of quiet. So rest your forehead. And let's practice our slow breathing. And we'll just start to walk our hands back in. If the cat's just jumped up on your back, it might be time to take the cat off. We're going to come forward and come all the way down to lie down on your tummy. Okay, so from here our hands would be just straight underneath our shoulders. Keep the legs nice and strong. Roll your shoulders back and down. And let's do that one more time. Roll the shoulders back and down. Alright, bring the elbows in. So again, we anchor our feet to the floor to support our spinal back bend. And with our breath, we'll move in and out of this as well. So a dynamic movement. Inhale, lifting up. And exhaling, coming down. So if you can practice breathing into your belly, you'll feel that it'll lift you a little bit. Inhale, lift. And exhale, lower. Inhale, lift. Keep the legs strong. So we want to not hinge from our lower back, but try to open up our upper back. So the upper back opens, the chest opens, and then we come back down. So we're moving with our breath, opening our thoracic spine. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. From here, we'll rest our forehead on the floor and then stretch out your right arm so it's in line with your shoulder. I'll just show you on this side so you can see. So your right arm will be reaching out long this way and you can turn towards the front. Now rest your head down. If you need a cushion underneath your head, that's okay too. Good, you know. Now what we're practicing here, we're working on stretching and opening the chest, shoulder and bicep so that arm stretches. This might be enough for your shoulder. You never move into anything that might feel like it's pinching or any pain. But if you'd like to extend the stretch further, you bend your left knee. So the right arm is out and the left knee bends up. And then you're rolling over towards that right arm just where you can feel the stretch through the shoulder and the chest. For some of you, your knee might be still on the floor and you're just sitting, resting this way. Some of you might need to go that little bit further around until you feel a stretch in the arm. You're in control of this one, so if you feel like it's too much, you just roll back onto your tummy again. I will stay here for a few breaths. You can close your eyes. I'll let you know when we're coming out of the pose. Breathing. You practice slowing it down even more. Maybe there's tension held in your body that's unnecessary that you can let go of right now. Two more breaths. So we're just going to gently roll back to our tummy again. And once you get there, legs come down, right hand slides in underneath the shoulder, and the left arm reaches out long. And you turn your head to look towards the right hand and rest it off the floor. So you'll know that both shoulders feel a little bit different, very normal. So if you feel like this is enough, then just stay here, don't do anything more. Otherwise, bend the knee, bend your right knee this time, and then roll over to your side. You just go where you can feel a stretch. And just breathing slowly. Just taking your time now, we'll roll back over onto our tummy and then bring the left hand in. Lift ourselves all the way up onto all fours. Tuck your toes under and begin to downward facing dog. And we pedal through the feet, so we bend the right knee and press the left heel towards the floor. And then change to the other side. And again, change. And change. Now please stay here if this feels good for you, but if not, come to your knees if it's too hard on your arms, shoulders or wrists. And instead you can push one heel out like this so your knee is bent and press one heel back and bring it in. And then change to the other side and you can do it this way. So pressing all the way back. One heel and then the other. One more time. One heel. And then the other. We'll bring your right knee forward into pigeon pose now. So right knee comes up to the right wrist. You could bring your foot across a little bit here and slide the other leg back. We have a few alternatives for this pose, but first let me set you up here. You can bring your arms forward and bring your head down towards the floor. You could bring your hands in underneath your forehead. Or even stay up on your forearms if that's a bit strong. This foot can come in really close if you need it to. Or further away if you feel like you want to stretch a little bit further. If you have a sore knee and hip, this is the best option, lie down on your back. And bring the right foot over the left knee and then bring the leg in this way. Hold this stretch instead. Takes all the pressure out of the knee joint and we're just only focusing on the glute muscles to stretch there. So just stay in that pose where you are. And we'll stay in the pose for 2 minutes here. So just make sure you're comfortable. If at any time that you start feeling a little bit more tension building in the body, then come back up a little bit. You can always come up and then move from side to side. Sometimes I find this is really good if I find that I'm a bit tight in my body and I need to move a little. I'll just rock a bit back and forward through the joint, through the hip joint, and then I'll come back into it slowly. So we're just always reminding our body that we're in a safe place, the body's safe to move, and then it'll let go. As soon as it starts feeling unsafe, it holds on really tight. So we breathe in and exhale slowly. Now you might even notice in this pose when you're in it that you're holding tension in your jaw. Let it go now. Just let your jaw go. Maybe it's in your neck. It's time just to relax your neck right now. Maybe we hold a lot of tension through our shoulders. And let it go. Just stay where you are. We'll lift up, we walk the hands back in, and maybe to downward facing dog again. If you're lying on your back, just stay where you are, and then we'll just switch over to the other side, okay? So we'll move into down dog and press all the way back. Just take your time, it's okay, just take your time. There's no hurry. We'll change sides now, so we'll bring the left knee forward. We want to make sure that the knee sits across to the left side of the mat as well. But sometimes when we first practice, people tend to bring the knee across their body, but we want to make sure that we keep it on the left side. So left knee to left wrist, and then come down. And then the hips are actually squared up in pigeon pose. We're not sitting down on our side this way. A good rule of thumb is the top of the knee is down on the floor and all of your toes are down on the floor like that. And then your hips will be in the right spot. So come down into your pose, elbows on the floor, or maybe you're reaching your arms all the way forward. You could bring your foot up higher if you choose. You'll notice if it's not in the right spot, your knee, your knee might not like it. So you can always change where you are. Come all the way down, rest your head. So again, once you establish your pose right now, then we start to look at and observe where we might be holding tension in the body. So just do a little scan, maybe holding your hands really tight. Just breathe out and release your hands. Maybe it's the forearms or your elbows. Let it go. Maybe it's the breath again, maybe holding the breath again. Sometimes that can be a habit too, if we're in a lot of stress regularly, that we tend to hold our breath quite a lot. So it's nice just to come back to observing it and changing that habit. Nice slow breathing. And we'll slowly start to walk our hands back up again. And then we'll bring the back leg all the way around to the front. If you're lying down, just come back up into a sitting position. We'll face the front of the room. Now, when we're sitting, if you want, you could use a block or a pillow or something to sit on. Let's just try this out. Sit with your legs out straight. And if you feel like you're sort of sitting a little bit like this, then you might need to prop yourself up with something. So I like to use a block or a cushion or even a bolster if you've got your bolster and you can sit this way. It just helps your body to be more aligned, and you'll feel much more comfortable through your hips and your back. Otherwise, we're all just sitting straight like this. Now we'll move a little bit dynamically. So the first thing we'll do slowly, and then we'll speed it up just a little bit. So we'll reach our arms forward this way, and then just tilt forward. This is only maybe 50% of your reach, so forward, and then we'll reach back again. Then we're going to bend down. I'm going to give you a couple of options again. Stay here if you're comfortable, just stay here. If you need a pillow or a bolster or something, you can bring them underneath your knees. This is actually really nice, especially if your hamstrings are super tight. So you pop the bolster here, and then you can even rest your elbows on your knees and rest your head this way. And it's really nice for your back as well. If you have a sore lower back and you're trying to lean forward, it can put a lot of pressure through your lower spine. So if your knees are bent like this, it takes all that pressure out of the lumbar spine, and you can just lean forward a little bit. So you can stay here like this. Or if you don't have a cushion, you could even just bend your knees a little bit and rest over them like this. We'll stay here for about four more breaths, just nice and slow. The top. Take your hands behind you, just lift up through your chest, have a stretch, even point your toes down. And come back. Walk your feet in. Feet come together, knees apart. Hold on to the toes, lift your body up. Maybe you're sitting on a block, or maybe you need to get a cushion and put it in underneath your thigh here, or a block or something, in case your knees are a little bit sore, or you need to take a bit of pressure out of your hips. You can put one on each side, and it just helps the support for your hips. But otherwise, you can stay here like this and take a breath in, and you can even lean forward, breathing out. We'll stay here for a couple of breaths. We won't force this, just let your head relax over. Even close your eyes and soften through your face. If leaning forward isn't in your practice today, that's okay. You could put your hands behind you like this and stretch up tall. And just activate the muscles in the legs to help the knees come down to the sides a little bit. You know, yoga is for everybody. And there's always a pose that you can do to suit your body. We just need to know how to modify it. So as we move along, I'll try as hard as I can to show you lots of different variations. And then you take those options to suit your own body. So we want to feel the benefits of health, vitality, calm and peace. We don't want to add on any extra stress to ourselves. Yoga is about coming back to the self. Okay. So let's from here come all the way up. Take the legs out wide. Again, you could be sitting on a block. Let's take them where they feel comfortable. All right, ready for some dancing? We're going to lift up our right arm and side bend just a little way. Don't go all the way over. Come back. And the other side. And then back. And again, side bend. And back. And side bend. And back. Side bend. And back. And side bend. And back. Good. Now let's stay on one side. So right arm up, side bend. Maybe you stay here. Or your hand might be here. You could come over a little bit further. You know how far you can go, reaching up. You want to open up through the shoulders. Keep extending and reaching. Maybe your hand touches your foot. Or maybe not. You're just reaching up here. Keep breathing. Two more breaths. rather than feeling like you have to come down, think about reaching up through this top side of the ribs, inhale and expanding up, and really finding more length and more space in your body, and come back. Let's change. Left arm up and side bend. So reach tall, open the body and breathe. Let's expand that left side of the body, create more space in your body as you extend and reach. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Come all the way back. We'll stay here a little bit longer. Just realign your spine. Make sure you're sitting really tall. And then you can have your hands in front. Now either you're staying here, maybe your hands are behind you, or you can walk your hands forward more on the floor. Take your time, very slow. You might get to a point where you feel like everything tightens up. If that's happening, come back a little bit. Just relax your legs, move them back and forth, back and forth. Take a breath in, exhale. Starts to relax, it can come down maybe a little bit further. Just let your body be where it is, calming the mind, calming the breath. Two more breaths, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, slowly walk your hands back in, bring your legs in one at a time, I'm going to turn ourselves around to lie down on the floor. Bending the knees, come all the way down. Rest your head on the ground. Right, from here, we'll take our hands apart just a little bit and walk our feet over to the sides of our mat. So feel the edges of your mat with your feet and your knees are apart a little. And just like windscreen wipers, we're going to roll our knees over to the right side, rolling to the edge of our feet. And then coming back and rolling over to the other side. And coming back up and rolling over to the right side. And moving back up to the top and moving over to the left side. And coming back up to the top. We'll do that one more time on each side, right side. And back. And left side. And back. Bring your feet in a little bit closer together. Bring your right knee in towards your chest and give it a hug. Good. We want to try to bring the lower back into the mat. Keep squeezing the knee in. You could stay here or stretch the left leg out along the floor and keep the knee drawing in towards you. Of course, if this feels too much, you can always bring your foot back with your knee bent. We'll move in and out of a hamstring stretch here, so we're holding the knee and we'll straighten the right leg up and hold the back of the thigh and then bend the knee again and bring it in towards the chest and stretch it back up towards the ceiling, drawing it in. Bend the knee, draw it in, just moving in and out and hold the back of the thigh, lift up your leg, wherever it goes, that's fine. Bend the knee, draw it in. And then lift the leg up and we'll hold that hamstring stretch. Maybe you're here, maybe your knee's a little bit bent, that's okay. If you can go any further than that, the leg is straight. Maybe you're walking hands up towards your calf muscle or up towards the foot. The knee could be bent again, as I said before, or stretched out along the mat. You just go where your body takes you today. Relax your shoulders down a little bit more. Soften through your face. Breathe in and breathe out. Inhale and exhale. You try to breathe down into the belly. Inhale, belly rises. And breathe out, the belly falls. Bend the knee again. Keep the right knee in where it is. Stretch out the left leg along the floor if it isn't already. And then hold onto the knee with your opposite hand and take the knee across your body. So you're holding the right knee with your left hand and take it over. And then you could reach the right arm out along the mat and look towards your hand. Or you might even just be going a little bit halfway. So the knee might just go across a little way. And maybe you're not even turning your head today. Just go where you know that the stretch is okay for you. Or you could take it all the way across. Again, we'll readjust the shoulders to make sure both right and left shoulder blade stays on the floor. And we'll come back into the center, hold the right knee, and let's bring the other knee in as well. Okay, so we'll hold the left knee and take the right foot to the floor, or stretch it out along the ground. So you have those two options. The lower back is on the floor. We want to keep the chin tilted down a little bit so we have length through the neck. Alright, so from here, let's straighten out the left leg, hold the back of the thigh, hamstring stretch, and then bend your knee again and squeeze it in. We'll just move in and out of this pose a couple of times. So up, straightening the leg, and then back and squeeze the knee in. And again, lifting up, stretching, and then bending the knee. And lifting, and then bending the knee. And this time we'll take the leg up and keep it up into a hamstring stretch. So hold the back of the thigh again, wherever you can. Knee could be a little bit bent here. We want to stretch out through the hamstrings. The legs can get quite tight, especially around the hips if you've been sitting for a lot of the day today at home, in the office, or in the car. Just breathing gently. You might notice that the longer that you hold the stretch in comfort, the more it will give you a little bit more, even if it's a millimeter. You just work on millimeter movements just to release through the body tension. The knee, bring it back in. We'll straighten out that right leg if your knee is bent, and we'll take it into a twist. So hold on to the knee with your right hand and then take it across your body, gently turning your head towards your hand. Again, you just take it where you can, so the knee there or all the way across, and breathe. Inhale and exhale. You could close your eyes. Just readjust the shoulders so they stay on the floor. Settling into this gently and slowly. We'll move back to the middle. Hold on to that left knee and hold on to the right knee. Gently rock across the lower back from side to side. Maybe you're holding the tops of your knees, maybe underneath your knees on your thighs, that's fine too. And we'll just make some small circles around our lower back, so you draw your knees in and circle them out and in and out. And then the other way, bring the knees in and circle them around and out back. And again, drawing the knees in and around and back. Place our right foot back on the floor again, and then our left foot on the floor. Take our hands down by our sides, both of our knees are still bent. Reach the right arm all the way up and over the head, palm facing up, and then turn your head to look towards the left shoulder. So stay there, And breathe slowly, just releasing through the shoulder joint. Now when we're here in this stretch, sometimes our back arches up off the floor. So just start to breathe slowly and settle the ribs down a little bit more. If this arm doesn't reach the floor on the other side, that's okay. You can bend your elbow out to the right side, make like a cactus arm and rest it like that. Take some pressure out of your shoulder. One more breath in. And exhale. Turn your head back to the ceiling. Lift your right arm in the air. And then take it all the way down to the floor. And let the right arm relax completely on the ground. Lift the left arm in the air. And take it all the way over your head where you can. Maybe your elbow needs to bend out to the side, and that's okay. Or your arm could be straight. Then we turn our head and look over the opposite way towards the right shoulder. Start to soften the ribs down if they feel like you're making an arch in your back. Just breathing slowly. Let your head feel heavy on the floor where it is. No force. We're starting to slow down towards meditation. Breathe in and breathe out. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Turn your head back to the center. Lift the left arm in the air. Bring it all the way down by your side. Turn both of your palms up, facing the ceiling and a little bit away from your body. From here, you could stretch your legs out along the mat in Savasana, which is our relaxation pose. Or if you feel like it's a bit uncomfortable for your lower back, you could put your bolster in underneath your knees. Or a pillow, if you have a pillow or something, just like this. You have plenty of time if you want to grab one. And then rest your hands facing up. And then settle your ribs down, lower back down. Maybe your neck, your chin feels like it's pointing up towards the ceiling this way. So you might even need to put a cushion in underneath your head just to relax your head down and the chin comes down, which will help to induce relaxation. We'll stay here in which pose feels comfortable for you. And then gently close your eyes. We're staying here as we move through a meditation. Inhale, feel the belly rise. And exhale, the belly falls. Inhale, feel the belly rise. And exhale, the belly falls. Breathing in. And breathing out. Softening through the face, the forehead, your eyebrows, the eyes and behind your eyes. Your jaw. Whole head and face. The shoulder blades heavy. Resting on the floor. The knees and your feet. The whole body. The whole body. Breathing in and breathing out. Visualize an energy that surrounds your entire body, from the crown of your head, around your face, around recognize this energy as a golden light filled with strength, protection, and healing. Now, as you visualize this golden light, as you breathe in, the golden light expands around you, creating more space. And as you exhale, you can relax fully into this space right now. Inhale, this energy expands around you. And exhale into this cocoon of safety. Inhale, expanding. Exhale into tranquility. We use this time as a pause in our day to recenter and rebalance, to come back to this place of peace within ourselves. To rest right now. Allow yourself this next minute of surrender. Completely allow yourself to be here right now. Exhale slowly. Take your awareness all the way down to your feet. Visualize yourself standing on the earth, strong, grounded. Start to move your toes just a little now. If you'd like to take a stretch, you could reach your arms over your head. Stretch your whole body out. Please take your time. You can keep your eyes closed the whole time. Bring the knees in towards your chest and gently rock across your lower back. You might like to roll over to one side before you come back to sit in an upright position. As I sign up very quietly this evening, so you can continue to keep that peace within you, just tread lightly. Have a beautiful sleep. We'll see you in the morning for gentle yoga at 9:15. It was lovely having time with you again. I can feel your presence here with me. Namaste.